This is the month of November, our month of release of blessings. Amen. Amen. Celebrate Jesus. We all know that even when God, in the beginning, right from the first verse, what God started with was to bless us with blessings, even during creation. Before he spoke about what is called blessing, which we always read in Genesis 1:26, he had already given us blessing. So we are going to look at the blessings that God has given unto us that were not specifically spoken out in that word blessing, but it is actually blessings that God has released. Nevertheless, for you to know that God always wants to bless us, he said unto us in his word, in the book of Numbers 6, verse 23, commanding Aaron the priest. That means that God has commanded me, commanded Rachel, commanded everyone that he has called. He said, for my children that you are speaking to, you should always speak word of blessings upon your life. Amen. So even when we are not repeating specifically what God has asked Moses to tell Aaron and his children as priests to be speaking to the congregation, but he gave us a pattern, a guideline for us to know that one of our duties is to prophesy and to decree blessings upon the congregation that God has given unto us to be an overseer over. And because when we speak those blessings, we are calling the angels of God to go into work, and we are calling God to certify that which he has spoken, because it's a God that does not fail. Amen. Amen. So he said in the book of Numbers 6, he said, speak unto Aaron and unto his son, saying, this is our verse for the month, saying, on this wise you shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them, and I believe you will be saying amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee.
Amen.
The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious amen. Upon thee.
Amen.
The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee
amen.
And give thee peace.
Amen.
And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel amen. And I will bless them.
Amen.
So he said that after this word has been spoken, he said, put my name. How do we put God's name upon you? It's by telling you everything about God, so that God will become meaningful in your life to the extent that you will be a bearer of that name physically and spiritually.
Amen.
He said, put my name upon them. After all these blessings, during these blessings, before these blessings, as you are blessing them, let them know that I have come to bless them. And your capital of them all. You remember my friend, my Adobeke. Is that my name be upon their lives. Because it is in the name of Jesus, in the name of God Almighty, that every knee. That is why I say, put my name upon their lives. So as we pray, as we decree, as we bless, we are automatically, because God is the doer of all things. He's the beginning and the end, the Alpha Omega, the one that was not created that created everything. That is the God that has all things in control. The Bible said that in him were all things created, and in him all things what consist. He is a container that carries us all. That is why this earth, they say it is water and cloud and everything. I mean, I always imagine, how did he put sand into this earth? How? And this is not the foundation. Water is under, lava is under, fire is under. How he did one? God is just too much. And this is the same God that says, place my name, so that everything that is in me can be transferred unto them, which is the completeness of his blessing. But we are going to start gradually in the teaching. He said, the Lord bless thee and keep thee.
Amen.
make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Genesis 1:1 to verse 4. It said in the a bit of verse 3. No, verse 4, I'm right, verse 4. It said in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. In the beginning. And we read this every day, we don't even know that it is blessing. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. He said, and the earth was without void and form, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. But the first word was, in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth. Before the heaven and the earth was created, it was already created. And if you have this blessing in your life, there is no goal of yours, there is no goal of mine that will not be achieved and accomplished. Creating what you want to create before it is created. In the beginning, God created. This is a blessing because he said, ye are gods. But it is when we don't have this wisdom and knowledge in us, he said, that is why we will die as ordinary men. But for us to live as God on this earth, we should learn to finish the work even before we start it. It is called, what God said is called imagination. This is a gift of the mind that he has given us. Imagine the goal, imagine the nation, imagine the accomplishment before you even start. Look at God said, I have already created the heaven and the earth. And the next verse said, everything is scattered. Everything is scattered. There is no life anywhere, no light. But you just said you have created everything. I mean, not before we read that.
Yes.
You said you have created the heaven and the earth. How come is it? Yes. Because the book of Corinthians said unto us, he said, the weapon of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of what? Of strongholds, casting down imagination and everything that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. That was why that he will have his goal, he will have his focus, he will have his vision alive. He said, I have finished the work. The blessing of faith, the blessing of the spirit of wisdom. He said, I have finished the work. He said, but the work, it's just like when Lazarus died. They said, Lazarus is sick. He said, living. He was preparing himself. Lazarus is dead. He said he's sleeping. He is sick. Go and pray for him. You say you are not praying. Now he's dead. You said he's sleeping. Why? When he said he was not going to pray, he has imagined what he's going to do. He has finished the work even before he went there. That was how he could relax. Because he knew that that death, that sleeping, was for the glory of God. He has seen in a place of prayer. He has seen in a place of consulting God that what is my destiny? What is my next step? God has already revealed unto him what is going to happen. He has that vision already. So every other thing that is happening, he said, you can't force me to do it before the time. So cool down, Lazarus, I'm coming. So now it says in the beginning, just at the beginning, not in the middle, not in the end, right at the beginning, before he started anything, he has finished creating. May God give you the power of true imagination in wisdom and knowledge.
Amen.
In your mighty name, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
That you will know what you need to imagine and stay in it. You will be able to have vision and goals and the power to accomplish it, to settle it, for you to, no matter what is coming around, for you to stand and move forward. May God give you that grace, that blessing in the mighty name of Jesus. That was why I said we didn't know that it's a blessing. We thought that it was just what God has done. This is the power of God. But it's a blessing that he has released unto us. Because Jesus said, as I am, so are you. As he is, so are we in this world. As God is, that is the book of 1 John 4:14. As God is, so are we in this world. So when God is saying, I finished the work, he said, my son, start thinking like that. My daughter, start thinking like that. Whatever it is you want to do, before it is done, be saying it already, that I have completed it. Be saying it, that is the gift of prophesying. Start saying it, that I have it already. Start saying it, I have accomplished it already. Is it visa? Nobody they pursue me. I've already gotten it. Is it passport? Nobody they send me anywhere. I already have it. Is it children? Who won't stop me before? My God is full of fruitfulness. I have every, the sex that I want, boy or girl, the gender I want, boy or girl, I have it. Is it money? Until it comes to pass, money is coming to me, yafun. The angels of God are bringing money. That is why I always like when my darling will say his private jet is parked there. Woo! I said that like papa, like begin and like mother. Woo! Because myself, I get private jet.
Amen.
Amen. Dream it until it comes to pass. Amen. It said the Spirit of God move upon the face of the water. Second blessing that God has given unto us. Revealed at the beginning, and yet we thought it was revealed only at the end. Because Jesus Christ was going, and Jesus Christ said, I will not leave you empty. I will not leave you famine. I will not leave you alone. I will send another helper, Paracletos, that will help you as standby, an advocate. But this advocate has been given right from the beginning. No wonder those who were wise in the Old Testament were able to connect and acquaint themselves with him. And they were able, the Bible says, the Spirit of God came upon them. They were accomplishing great things. Because they saw the blessing that God gave right at the beginning. He said, the Spirit that is within you will make you to do exceedingly great things. Above what is being taught, above what is being imagined, according to the power that is within. Second blessing that God gave unto us right from the beginning, the blessing of his Spirit. He's telling us that whatever thing you imagine, whatever goal, without his Spirit, it will come to pass. As for a Christian, at times it comes to pass because even your spirit is very strong. Oh yes. But we are talking of involving God's Spirit into our spirit, so that his name will be glorified in everything that we do. And to tell you that there is something inside you, his own likeness that he has put inside you, that once you are determined to do something and to get something, the devil cannot stop you. That is why he said, whose spirit? He said it was the Spirit of God. So if your spirit agree with your goal, you have already received the blessings of the manifestation of that goal, of the manifestation of that blessing. Because you hold on to it and you say, no way, this one I will complete it. This one I will see the end of it. So that means that your spirit is talking into that situation. Just as the Spirit of God over the place that was void and without form, that not it was empty and without shape. But as much as your spirit look over the situation, look over the project, look over the matter, and you say within you, it is possible. For with God, all things are possible. I tell you, that is one of the greatest blessings that God has given us. The blessing to blessing to accomplish all without failing. And I decree that blessing, which we know as the spirit of faith, which is different from the gift of faith. The gift of faith is what helps you to do miracles. It helps you to help other people. The spirit of faith helps you yourself. Hallelujah. You don't hear what I just said? The gift of faith enables you to help others. The spirit of faith helps you to help yourself. Because it is within you. It's not something that comes upon you, which is a gift. Because gifts are given to profit without. That is what the Bible says. It is given so that the church will profit. But when it comes to your spirit, the gift that God has put into your spirit, it is something that helps you and helps me.
Amen.
Do you understand? So, I decree that the spirit of faith, I decree that the spirit of faith that will make you to accomplish your goals and experience the blessings of God, that spirit of faith be given unto you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Ghost, receive his spirit of faith into your spirit in Jesus' name. My share, as I'm explaining, I will be declaring. Because he said, put my blessing upon them. You will be receiving in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He says, and then God looked and he said, let there be light. Do you see that despite the fact that the Spirit of God is there, despite the fact that the Spirit of wisdom is there, despite the fact that faith is there, he said, without illumination, without light, you will not be able to see as far as you are supposed to accomplish. Without light, there will be a limitation. So God went to give us a third blessing. And he says, let there be light. So that everything in heaven and everything on earth can be done. So that the goal of your life can be accomplished. He said, let there what? Be light. And the Bible says, as you speak light into your goal, as you speak light into your project, as you speak light into your vision, you will see that help will start coming around you. You will see that you will be doing exceedingly greater than you think, and so shall it be for you. Receive light in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you, my grandson. Light entered. And look at God started accomplishing everything. Just as I'm telling you, stage by stage. This is when they will say that they are writing a 7 points for success. Stage by stage. That if you are following it, and I myself am following it this way, that I'm speaking. You know, anytime we come here to preach, I also preach to myself. Oh, this one will be saying, now God, they talk. Then later I will go and sit down and become a student. How many times daddy will put that same? I said, daddy, please leave me. Let me listen to Pastor Rachel. Pastor Rachel is talking to Rachel.
Amen.
Daddy said, but you're the one. I said, that is Pastor Rachel. This is Rachel. And then I'll be listening to Pastor Rachel. When I listen to Pastor Rachel, Pastor Rachel prays, I say, amen. And at times, Pastor Rachel will say some things that I will make, wow. I didn't even know that when I was preaching. So I talk to you now, but I go back and listen to who? Pastor Rachel. To hear what God is saying to who? To Rachel. So when light came in, things started happening. He said the light came in, and the light was so strong that darkness could not stand. Meaning, whatever would have been able to disturb your project, whatever would have been able to disturb your goal, because the light of God has flourished and flooded into the project, all the darkness they fly.
Yeah.
Say amen to that.
Yeah.
The Bible said that he divided the light from the darkness. He said this is what you should look for you to have success. I'm not saying that darkness is not there, but I've given you the blessing of light. Don't concentrate on the darkness. Don't concentrate on the power of darkness. Don't concentrate on how they want to distract you. Don't concentrate on what? Hey, now my father family, my mother family. that will make you to see so that you can accomplish what you need to do. So God has put a separation. That is another blessing. He put a separation so that, and he's telling us with wisdom, say, don't concentrate. They offend me, I can't forgive. Leave that thing. Leave that distraction. Concentrate on the light. That which will make you to grow. That which will make what you have programmed to come to pass. He did me this. She did me that. Leave her. It's a distraction. Darkness is always there. Darkness is always there. The Bible said the darkness was meant to rule the night. And the light to rule the day. But to God be the glory. That even in the night, darkness don't have power. Why? Because there is what is called moon. That the program of the day, when the light of the day, they told us, and yet it said that moon does not have light. Moon is lighted by the sun. And the sun is meant to rule the day. Meaning that if I take care of my day very well, when night comes and darkness want to walk, my light will shine into that darkness. Amen. And that darkness will not be able to stand.
Amen.
Because that darkness will not become light that we walk together for my good.
Amen.
Did you get that blessing there?
Really?
Come on, say hallelujah to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is why it is being separated. Witchcraft power is being separated. It's not as if we don't know that they are there, but they are being separated. Separated because we have power over them. Your occultic powers are being separated. No matter what they are doing, what we should concentrate ourselves on is the light. And that means that it's Jesus said, I must do the work when it is day. For the night cometh when no one can walk. So during the day, I fast. During the day, I pray. During the day, I read the Bible. During the day, I meditate upon the word of God. So that when night is coming, I will not be weak. My light will be so shining. Your light will be so shining. That the moon that is supposed to fight against us will become so wicked that he will need my light to shine. You know what I've just said now? When he says that I will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemy, that is what I've just said. When he prepared those people who says you're not going to die for you, they will now become those who is looking up to you.
Amen.
The moon look up to the sun for it to be bright. She can never be bright on her own. That is how it will be. Everyone that seek your downfall, they will look up to you to become acknowledged by anybody. In the mighty name of Jesus. And may God give us the wisdom to understand when God is doing that. Amen. Because our mindset is always to destroy them. They don't do good and take revenge. But the mindset of God is saying, let them be. It is more profitable to concentrate on the light than to acknowledge the darkness. We are not saying that you should be in ignorance, but have the full confidence that they cannot do you anything. And their total failure is sure in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said their total failure is sure in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us continue. That is why the Bible said that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John 1:4. He said in him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in darkness, and darkness could not understand. When Jesus is there, the darkness cannot stand. When Jesus is there, it becomes a mystery to the power of darkness. To evil ones that are fighting you, it becomes a mystery. How you take the escape? That is the mystery. They cannot understand. How you take the escape? We did this, we did that, yet you are still moving forward. How you take the escape? Christ in me, my hope of glory. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. For he is my strength. He is my shield. He is my buckler. Amen, somebody. I like that when he said the life of Christ is the light of us, the believers. His life, which we are going to partake today in the Holy Communion. That light that we are talking about, that light that is able to be illuminated, to shine, that it makes us to be able. At times we always say, let me draw myself. You have forgotten that he said, I give you power to be world. Deuteronomy 8:18. He said, all power belongs to God. This money you are calling your own, the life that you have yourself, it is God that gave it to you. Everything, it is Him. He said, the life of Jesus became our light. No wonder He said to Joshua, meditate upon the word. Let it not depart from you, and you will have good success. For the life of Jesus, living like Jesus, putting Jesus into you, making Jesus your Lord, making Jesus your Savior, submitting to Jesus. He said it's the lifestyle. He's the life that make your light to shine.
Amen.
The mentalness not to be able to stay inside you. No wonder, no matter what they do, no matter how they trouble you, no matter how they trouble me, no matter how they poison, they kill Ramasuta Labaya, Rico Soto Lobahete. He said, if you drink any poisonous thing, both in the night and in the day, he said, it will not harm you. That is the life of God that has become your light, that will make you to decree the rightful things. You will not, even when your mind wants to think something that is bad, because our mind do think bad things. My own too. I'll be your pastor, my own too. At times, fear will come, things will come. But even in that, the words of my mouth will be, Father, you have everything in control. This situation will not overcome me. But in your name, I overcome the situation. In your name, I will give testimony. And do you know that during that time, at times, that is when it looks as if the situation doesn't want to go? It looks as if the problem is even getting stronger? Just keep believing it. Keep saying it. For those who have faith, they are those who please God. Those who have faith, they are those who make God to be happy. And when that spirit of faith is in you, it makes you to know that no matter what the situation, God, you are still my God. And because I trust in you, you will reward me. Meaning, I will not fail, which is another blessing. I will not fall, which is another blessing. All things work out together for my good, which is another blessing. And the devil will keep looking, and he will be accusing God. He said, you are doing partiality. Is it not you that covered her? Is it not you that covered him? Why did you give him that wisdom? That is why he ate that poison. The poison did not kill him. That is when we said, she will not get that job, but she still went there. She got the job. Are you not the one? Are you not the one? Hey, stop doing good to her. Stop blessing her. And see, she will praise you. God will say, leave that thing. Even if I leave her totally and ask you to punish her, and ask you to suffer her, leave that thing, because she will always serve me.
Amen.
That is what, because you have faith. He said that you believe that God is God. I believe that God is God, and is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So you will see God telling Satan, the devil, the accuser. I said, don't worry. She's my daughter. He is my daughter. He's my son. Even if she's poor than the poorest in this world, she will still serve me. Even he is poor, and with any kind of sickness in her, in him, they will still serve me. I have proved them in so many ways, and I know they are my own. Because Jesus, who is our life, is our light.
Amen.
So he illuminates and puts sense into our mind. By the power of his spirit, He said His Holy Spirit is our teacher, who will teach us everything that we need to know. The book of 2 John, or rather 1 John chapter 2. You don't need to go there. Who will teach us everything that we should know, so that we don't fear. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So He said, also in the book of John 12, such confidence that Jesus has, He said again unto them, I am the light of the world. He that follow me shall not do what? Walk in darkness, but shall have the light of what? Of life. John 8:12. I am the light of the world. That is what Jesus said. He said, he that follows me shall not walk in darkness. Say, I have the blessing of light. I have the blessings of light, which is now my light. So I will not walk in darkness. In your mighty name, O Jesus. Amen. He said, the light of the world is who He is. He that follow me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have what? The light of life. He said in the book of Psalms, He said, my word is the light that lightens your path.
Right on.
My word lightens your path.
Yeah.
So when you said in the beginning, I create this, I create the heaven and the earth of my home. Haraboshita. And it is always good for the husband and wife to have common knowledge in what we are teaching. There is always trouble in the home, in the family, when it is one of them that have what? This kind of knowledge. So one will be speaking darkness, the other will be speaking light. He says, if the light of your eyes is dark, He said, the darkness of your body is too much. He said, but if the eyes of your body is light, He said, you will do very great things. And you also find the book of John 8, but we are not going to die. Amen?
Amen.
God bless you, son. So the light of God. Problems are in the home. Problems are in the family. Not only because the one who have the light now became dominated by darkness instead of she or him to dominate the darkness. Because we did not ignore the darkness and concentrate on the light, even in our homes. Then darkness starts speaking. And the problem comes. Because you want to change that man. You want to change that woman. You don't concentrate in the light and concentrate doing good and concentrate being a good wife or concentrate being a good husband, so that the light of God will shine in you by you being the light of Jesus. Then we have problem in the home. Then the husband wants to leave the wife. The wife wants to leave the husband. Why? You are concentrating on darkness. This woman must change. This man must change. If you don't change, I will leave your house. If you don't change, I will divorce you. What the hell is wrong with you? He says, Jesus, He's our life. And that life is light. Be a Jesus in your home. Look at Jesus. When the sinners are brought to Him, what did He do? He forgave them. He did not condemn them. Where is it that you are the condemner of the sinner in your home? Are you Jesus? Did you shed your blood for them? Did you shed your blood for your husband? Did you shed your blood for your wife? Why are you always condemning? I mean, I don't say we don't correct ourselves. But we correct in love. There is always some things, but when you insist on what you are not supposed to insist on, you bring problems to the home. And God that has blessed you, that says, at the beginning I created heaven and earth. Instead of you not to be saying, I create my home, the beginning of my home and the end of my home. Meaning that everything in between will be perfect in the name of Jesus. Instead of you to say that,
for this house, oh, with the way where you dey be so. With the way where you dey do now today, be today. It's either you beat me or I beat you. If you don't kill me today, that me go kill you. You are telling darkness, come and start hovering. You are calling darkness, come and start hovering. And even as at that time when you say you want to start prayer, you don't already bring darkness. But the good thing about light is this. The good thing about light is this. Once light, darkness is not there. The day you determine to allow light to reign in your home, by living the life of Jesus, that is the day darkness flees. Once you make up your mind as a husband and as a wife, the darkness will go, because no matter how tiny the light is, it dominates the darkness. May the light of God lighten your life.
Amen.
May the light of God lighten your home.
Amen.
May you know the meaning of these blessings that God has given you, and start dwelling in these blessings so that you will be everything that God called you to be, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The light of the marriage is understanding. The light of the marriage is submission. The light of the marriage is forgiveness. The light of the marriage is love. Husband, love your wife. Wife, submit to your husband. The light of the marriage. Amen.
Amen.
Last week I spent 1 hour, no one spent 1 hour to the man and 11 minutes. So important is blind Bartimaeus. So important he understood what is called light. The enemy blinded him and he was a beggar. When light is not there, that is what you become, a beggar. The enemy dominated his life. He was a beggar. But one day he understood something. He said, am I not a son of David? Am I not a son of David? Has God not blessed me right from the beginning? Why should I remain in darkness under the oppression and suppression of Satan the devil? What is wrong with my mentality? That day, the one that is the word of God was passing by. Are you hearing me? Mark chapter 10 from verse 46. And then he cried, I want light today. My eyes have been blind. I have been a beggar in life. Everybody are doing great things. Even if he has built a house, he cannot see the house. The enemy paralyzed him, paralyzed his sight, paralyzed everything. He said, God, enough is enough. I knew you. It took light for you to be able to go as far as you could, and he still created today. He said he has rested, but things are still going on. Why? He has given my power to continue creation. He know that what God is still creating. He is God, but he made you to be God in his image and in his likeness. So today we are building great mansions. We are doing great things. It is still God through us that is still creating.
Amen.
We are using the resources that he has given to do a lot of miracles. So blind Bartimaeus was there, and he heard that the life that is the light of man was passing by. He screamed! He screamed! And he shouted, Jesus, the son of David, have mercy on me. Another blessing that makes us accomplish our goals. Sin has so much dominated us. Though his word said that sin will not dominate us. But at times as women, we refuse to go into the path of his righteousness. We are being deceived because we are concentrating on the darkness. So sin enters. He screamed, said, let the power of mercy speak for me. He's a son of David, 47. Have mercy on me. The people said, keep quiet. He said, for where? The life that needs to be in me so that I can become a light. a shining star that shines brighter and brighter until the perfect day. So that I will not be a beggar, they will be carrying me to this place and taking me home. I want to be the one that is leading people. I want to be the one that is blessing people. I want to be the one that is raising up generations. It is not that the little children will carry me, adults will carry me, but I want to carry myself. I want to go anywhere I want to go by myself. I want to do anything I want to do by myself. I need light in my life, and this light is found in Christ. So he screamed, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. They said, keep quiet. The Bible said, he cried the more. Una not like me. Una say, make I remain in darkness. It is well, my sister. It is well, my brother. And you are not helping me. It is well, my sister. It is well, my brother. You are giving me fish. You are not telling me how to fish. I will take care of this thing now, my brother. Wait, how your own paper they come out? I know that God does settle us in different ways. But there are some basic things that are necessary. Right. So instead of you to tell your brothers or your sister, he said, just they pray, no worry. Meanwhile, there are documents to be filled. There are requirements to be done. There are lawyers to be seen. He said, no. Now, just they pray, God is a rewarder. And then the light comes to your heart. Why? You say, no way, God will do it. I don't need heart. Why? But that was the light. Light came. Go and take a lawyer. Your own case, get a CB. You say, I don't want to spend money. But that was the light. You want to be some. You want to learn work? You call me Brother Francis. Brother Francis, how many years did you use? Sorry, Dickie Francis. How many years did you use? You went to do a course, 1 year, 2 years. Ah, no, I just want to do the work. You ignore the light.
2 hours. 6 months.
Do you understand?
Right on.
How is it that this woman says she says she's working? I did not lie. Now you get the certificate. She don't get certificate. Okay, now come work the work. You ignore the light. Somebody is making it in business. And the person said, this is, I invested in this, I invested in that. And God helped me. For sure, God help us in all these things. Because it is a life that becomes a light. I invested in this, my brother, why they deceive me now? Okay, now they pray. Prayer will help you, they pray. Not do anything, just sit down for hours, they pray. If it shall the roof go open, you go come drop money. If that is how it is, all those people that are fasting for 40 days and 40 nights, fasting 20 days, fasting 90 days, their money for don't pass money. But those who are fasting, there are those who will not, if you see their offering, you will know that Jesus is not in them. And Jesus needs to be in them. And then you see this shaku, this my shaku here, or any other person. Shaka. Then I tell you, you can't pull offering 50 euro, 100 euro. You don't know, say, you know the thing where you do. Yes, then when you come, they open. Say, this one with the dreadlock. God, you are cheating us. See, dreadlock, see, earring. This unserious human being. How can he be making it at me that I'm coming to talk? Every day, you only yakakuku yakari. He said, I will do the works of my father when it is still day, for the night will come when no one can walk. And Jesus in you is a light, and the life that brings the light. So it's a lifestyle to be connected with him. Doing what he asks you to do. It's not that you bring tithe here after you finish the whole tithe here, then you refuse to write application. When the pastor now tells you, go and meet the lawyer. He said, Pastor, the Lord is with me.
Yes.
Say, this pastor never know the pin where I give God. Say, this pastor never know the pin where I give God. If this pastor know the pin, why I give God? Now you give God, I mean, now you give God, and yeah, God give you. Does it mean that we should not sacrifice? That is not what I'm saying. Remember, last week we had this teaching. Nehemiah did not want them to reach their goal, to fulfill their goal. Sabinat and Tobias. They did not want Nehemiah to fulfill his goal in building. They started mocking. He said, can he sacrifice? Can they sacrifice? Will they go through the process that will make their goals to become accomplished? Will they indeed give an offering? The sacrifice is needed. The offering is needed. Your brain is needed. Your application is needed. The principles must be followed. The procedures must be followed. Even when you are bringing sacrifice to God. No wonder Jesus said, he said, you tithe in meat. For you do what? The wickedest things, which is love, which is doing good, which is following the word of God, you left it. And you thought that by your giving tithe and offering, things will work out for you. He said, you are giving meat. You are giving. He said that thing you are giving is a tiny thing.
You know.
The tiniest thing that you need to make it work. What you need most is you to allow the life which is hid in him is hidden. All wisdom, all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Let that life be your light. Let that life be your light. For blessings of light has been given unto us. Amen. So, blind Bartimaeus received his sight and he started seeing and he started giving praise to God. And that is why the book of Ephesians 1, I think we have to close now. 1:18 says, the eyes of your understanding, because of the spirit of wisdom, we treated it already last week. He said, the eyes of your understanding need to be enlightened, must receive light, so that you will know the hope of your calling and what the riches of the glory of inheritance is in the saints. And then he tells us, you are the light of the world. Matthew 5. John 8:12 said, I am the light of the world. If you follow me, he said, the light will shine through you. And then he says in Matthew 5, you are the light of the world. He said, you are such a light that you cannot be hidden. So you see that your projects that you need to do, your goals, your vision, when your understanding is enlightened, knowing that you are the light of the world, then you know that your goal, your visions that God has given you in the place of prayer is to showcase his glory to the world. Did you hear what I just said? It is to showcase. Jason is not Jason that is singing. Jason is singing to give glory to God. And I'm still waiting for him to join his music. Amen. Now stop missing it. Yeah, but the one I loved most was the one that he was praising God. Now I like pass, and I don't want to sell pass. It's a busy. Don't be God the giver of grace. Not mine. Now, the one that he called God and was giving praise to God, that was the one that sold more. I'm not the other. I don't know if they take a resemble, put a chalk all over his face. Thank God that when the light strike, he run. To show us that the power of darkness has nothing. When God did. Amen. So you are the light of the world, a city that is set on the hill that cannot be hidden. That is why your goals will surely come to pass. Amen. What you put your hand to do will surely come to pass. Amen. What you want to do will surely come to pass. I decree that all things work out together for your good. Your light will shine in Jesus' name. Your light will shine in Jesus' name. Your light will shine in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Your light will shine in Jesus' name. You will give light to your house. You will give light to your home. You will give light to your city. You will give light to your nation. You will give light to your country. In the mighty name of Jesus. By the power of God, I say your light will shine before men. Your light will not be hidden in the mighty name of Jesus. So that God be glorified in you, in Jesus' name. That is why he says, arise, shine, for your light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. He said, for darkness, he went back again to Genesis 1. He said, for darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. He said, but the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon you. And the Gentiles shall come to your light, and kings, according to what they sang and blessed, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Let us stand up. He said, after you have heard of this word, make up your mind to arise. Make up your mind to withdraw your goals. Make up your mind to withdraw your visions. He said, start dreaming again. He said, arise. For I have come to shine your light again. I have come to shine your light again. I have come to shine your light again. I have separated your light from the darkness. No matter how the darkness is big, from your family, from your foundation, no matter how great the darkness is, he said that darkness will not cover you. Because I have arisen upon you. I decree into your life that the Lord God Almighty rise upon you in your mighty name of Jesus. I decree upon your life that God Almighty rise upon you in your mighty name of Jesus. I decree upon your life that your glory shall be seen. The glory of God shall be seen upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. The glory of God shall be seen upon you. The glory of God shall be seen in your home. The glory of God shall be seen in the city because of you. The glory of God shall be seen in the nation because of you. The glory of God shall be seen in the country because of you. In the mighty name of Jesus. For Jesus, our Lord, has risen upon you in Jesus' name. He said, and I decree, Gentiles shall come to your light. Gentiles shall come to your light. And kings to the brightness of your rising. You will rise. You are rising from glory to glory. You are rising from honor to honor. You are rising in the mighty name of Jesus. You are rising in every areas of your life. You are rising, shining as the brightest star. You are rising, shining as the brightest star. You are rising. Your children are rising. Our children are rising. Our next generation are rising. Darkness will not cover them. The glory of God is upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, you shall do great things. Greater things shall you do. That the glory of God be seen upon your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, that project that you have started, you are going to accomplish it. You are going to finish it. In the mighty name of Jesus, that prayer that you have prayed and made you to cry, that prayer that you have prayed and made you to shed tears, even in the place you will be praying the prayer, you will be shedding tears. As from today onward, you will give your testimony, the testimony of joy, the testimony of joy, the testimony of jubilation, for your prayers are answered in Jesus. Thank you for what we have done. We thank you also for the blessings that you have blessed us. We thank you that you bless us with the blessings of imagination, with the blessings of purpose, with the blessings of knowing how to write down under our goals and vision. We thank you for the blessing of power that you have given unto us. We thank you also for the resources of light, the resources of faith, the resources of mercy that you have given unto us. And for that we know that we will never be a failure. But we will always have good success and prosper in every good things. For this we say thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.